Hello everyone, today we'll discuss about how to quantify information. As we discussed in the previous class, we considered three news headlines. One is sun rises in the east, there is heavy rainfall in Sahara Desert, Facebook is a social networking app. Which news headlines will give you the maximum surprise? Now we will look at the probability of occurrence of each headlines. We know that the headline number 1 occurs with probability 1 because everyone knows that sun rises in the east, sun will rise in the east. So the probability of occurrence of that particular event will be 1. And the headline number 2, heavy rainfall in Sahara Desert, the probability of occurrence of that particular event will be almost 0. And everyone knows that Facebook is a social networking app. So we can say that headline number 3 occurs with probability 1. Now we will look at the surprise element of each headlines. As we know that first headline has no surprise, while second headline has higher surprise. So we can say that the probability of occurrence of event is inversely related to surprise. Or we can say that as probability of occurrence of an event tends to 0, the surprise tends to infinity, right? While probability of occurrence of a particular event tends to 1, surprise tends to 0. As we know that the probability of occurrence of an event is a measure of uncertainty or unexpectedness of occurrence of that event. Again, we know that information is directly related to surprise. So here we can see that there is no surprise associated with first headline, more surprise associated with the second headline. So we can say that information is directly related to surprise, and again we know that surprise is inversely related to probability of occurrence. So generally we can say information is directly related to surprise and inversely related to probability of occurrence. So the information associated with an event E, I of E, is directly related to 1 by probability of occurrence of event E. Or we can say that information I of E is inversely proportional to the probability of occurrence of event E. Now we will look at how to define information. So from the above discussion, we can see that the information associated with an event E is directly proportional to 1 by probability of occurrence of event E. Or we can say that I of E equal to a function of 1 by P of E. So simply I will write it as I equal to a function of 1 by P. Now we need to find this particular function which satisfies the following conditions based on our previous discussion. Property number 1 is, as P tends to 1, information tends to 0. Property number 2 is, as P tends to 0, information tends to infinity. Consider messages designated by A and B with probability of occurrence P of A and P of B. If, say problem number 3 is, if P of A less than P of B, then I of A should be greater than or equal to I of B. Now fourth property is, we know that 0 less than or equal to P of A less than or equal to 1. Therefore, I of A should be greater than or equal to 0. Or we can say that information is non-negative. So consider an event E consists of two sub-events E1 and E2. Assume that the sub-events E1 and E2 are independent. Now what is the condition for independence? We have P of E equal to P of E1, E2. So if E1 and E2 are independent, then we can see that P of E1, E2 equal to P of E1 into P of E2. This is a condition for independence. Now we will look at the information associated with the occurrence of event E
which will be equal to the sum of information associated with the sub events E1 and E2. That is, information associated with event E should be equal to the information associated with the sub event E1 plus information associated with the sub event E2. Now, by definition of information, we have information I associated with event E equal to a function of 1 by P of E. Again, this can be written as a function of 1 by P of E1, E2. Since E1 and E2 are independent, this can be written as a function of 1 by P of E1 into P of E2. By the fifth property, we have information I of E equal to information I of E equal to I of E1 plus I of E2. So this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. By comparing equation 1 and 2, we have I of E should be equal to a function of 1 by P of E1 plus a function of 1 by P of E2. Now, the only function satisfying the above five properties is logarithmic function. Thus, information I can be defined as log of 1 by P. For information I of E can be written as log of 1 by P of E. Now, the unit of information depends upon the base of logarithm used. So, if the base is 2, then unit is bits. If base of logarithm is E, then unit is nat. Similarly, if base of logarithm is 10, unit is Hartley. In our syllabus, throughout we will use this particular definition. That is, information associated with the event E is log to the base 2, 1 by P of E bits. Now we will try to measure the information associated with an event of throwing of dice. So, the probability of getting a particular number while throwing a dice will be probability equal to 1 by 6. Now, as per the definition of information, I equal to log to the base 2, 1 by P, right? So, this will be equal to log to the base 2, 1 by 1 by 6. So, which will be equal to log to the base 2, 6 bits. Now, we will try to evaluate this particular quantity in calculator. So, log of 6. That is, information is log of 6. So, this will be 0.778. But the problem is, in calculator, by default, the base is 10. So, we need to convert the answer to bits. So, for that, what you need to do is, the resulting answer is divided by log 2. So you will get the answer in bits. So here the answer will be 2.58 bits. Now we will consider a second problem. A source emits 4 symbols with probability 0.4, 0.3, 0.2 and 0.1 respectively. Find the amount of information associated due to these 4 symbols. So we have P of 1 equal to 0.4, P of 2 equal to 0.3, P of 3 equal to 0.2 and P of 4 equal to 0.1. Now information associated with the first symbol is I1 equal to log 1 by 0.4. Similarly, I2 equal to log 1 by 0.3, I3 equal to log 1 by 0.2 and I4 equal to log 1 by 0.1. Remember, the log is to the base 2 and clearly you should write the units also, bits. So now I1 will be equal to, we will check, one divided by 2.5, so log 2.5. So you will get as 0.39. As I said earlier, divide your answer by log 2. So divide by log 2. So this will be equal to 1.32. Similarly, you will get it as 1.73, 2.32, 3.32. So total information I will be equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus I4. You will get it as some approximately equal to 8.7. So please prepare well for an online assignment scheduled in the next class. Thank you.